Welcome back to another Motion VFX Academy lesson. Today, Nick is going to run through how you can add effects in Final Cut Pro.
On top of all of the versatile built-in effects we became familiar with in the last movie, Final Cut has a robust collection of effects that we can add to clips from the effects browser. Let's start to become familiar with how we can search, preview, and apply effects to clips in our timeline. Along the way, we'll learn how to rearrange, manipulate, and save effects as a default or as presets to speed up our timeline workflow. Now I'm going to continue in the timeline I was using in the last movie. I'm going to move my playhead back 2 shots and then press Command-5 to bring up the effects browser. Currently, I'm in the video section where I have all selected, which will allow me to see every single effect that I have installed on my system, including any third-party effects. On the left-hand side, if I scroll down in video, I could go to a category such as light and see only effects that are associated with this section. Let me scroll back to the top of video and select all. You'll notice at the bottom of the effects browser is a magnifying icon as well as a search field where we could search for an effect by name. I'll click here and type in the word focus, and only effects with the word focus will show up. We can preview the effect over the clip that's in our viewer by skimming over the desired effect and seeing how it's going to mix in with our footage. We can also hold down the Option key to see different amount levels of the effect. As I drag to the left, this effect has less of an amount and influence on the clip, versus if I drag to the right, it's going to make a much blurrier image. If I would like to apply the effect, I could select it and drag and drop it directly over the clip. As of Final Cut 10.6, you can drag it into the viewer to perform either face or object tracking. I'm going to press Escape to release my mouse and then double click the focus effect in the browser to show the third way. I'll press Command-4 now to bring up my inspector, and you can see that the focus effect shows up at the very top of the video inspector. With it selected, we can see that it has an on-screen control. Several effects have these, and you can manipulate those parameters directly inside the viewer. If I deselect the effect, you'll notice that the on-screen controls go away. I'll select the focus effect by its name and drag the on-screen control up to the lady's face where I see that the center value is what it's associated with. All effects come with properties that you can also manipulate. In this instance, I'm going to adjust the amount value to be a little bit less, followed by the softness, but decrease the width and the height of the effect to narrow the in-focus range. If I would like to preview the result before my focus effect was applied to the clip, I can click the checkbox icon next to focus, or get rid of this effect entirely by selecting it by its name and pressing delete. I'll press Command Z to undo my operation, and just mention that at the top of every effect is your ability to reset the parameters to from everything underneath, or you can click the arrow next to the parameter to just reset the individual value. I'm going to click off, and let's add another effect to this clip. In this instance, under video, I'll head to the light category and then make sure to clear my search results. Here I'll find the glow effect, which I'll skim over to preview, and then double click to apply it to the clip. Notice that the glow effect is added after the focus effect. The order of effects matter inside a Final Cut Pro. If I were to select the glow effect and drag it up, I could change this order and now see that the glow is affected by the focus effect versus the focus having no influence on the glow when the order of these effects are reversed. I'll drag this effect up. I'll leave my move intact with the glow effect on top of the focus. If I wanted to disable both of these effects, I can now click the effects checkbox to turn off both added effects for glow and focus. I'll turn those back on. In order to speed up your workflow, Final Cut also allows you to save effect presets. I'm going to head to the bottom right-hand corner to click the Save Effect Preset button. We'll notice a very similar dialog box to what we saw when we pasted attributes from one clip to another in the last movie. In this case, let's give this effect a name. I'm going to call this Focus and Glow, and we'll save it to another category. And we'll save it to a new category from the category drop-down list called My Fave Effects. I'll choose Create. And just notice that the attributes selected that will be saved are my 2 added effects of glow and focus. I could also add built-in properties to be part of my effect preset. Keyframe timing is only necessary when you have keyframes on a clip, which is a discussion for another movie. I'm gonna press save, and if we look inside a video, we'll notice a new category called My Fave Effects with the focus and glow effect. I'll move to the shot after the one I had selected and just double click to apply that focus and glow, and then lower the glow amount so it's less of an effect. On top of saving presets, we can also make an effect a default and apply it with a keyboard shortcut. I'll select the focus and glow effect and right click it to make it a default video effect. I'll now move earlier in the timeline and head to my edit menu, where I can see that I can add the focus and glow from this dropdown or by pressing Option E. That preset is now applied. Now let's review all of this information. You can apply effects to clips using the effects browser. I'll head to the very top, where I'll select Video All, so we can see all of the video effects that we have installed on our system that come with Final Cut, as well as third-party effects. We can skim over an effect in order to preview it over a clip, as well as use the Option key to play with the amount value before applying it to the clip. Once you add an effect to a clip, you can click on the checkbox to enable and disable it, or head to the arrow in order to reset the parameter, as well as select the effect and press delete to remove it from the clip entirely. Lastly, an effect or collections of effects can be saved as an effects preset at the bottom right-hand corner of the video inspector. We can also make any effect we want accessible via a shortcut by making it a default video effect within the browser.